Assalamualaikum and good morning. Long time no see. Okay, how are you today? Lama tak nampak kan? Okay, welcome again to English class with teacher Maizatul. I've been giving you offline homeworks this week. So today we are back. Okay, teacher dah boleh Alhamdulillah ada kesempatan untuk buat video. Let's see. Today we are going English CFR Year 5 Unit 6 spot. Kita masih berada di unit 6, sport. Sport tu apa? Yes, sukan kan kalau perasan. Hari Ahad pun teacher ada bagi video untuk tengok jenis-jenis sukan, types of sport. Ada macam-macam, ada running kan, ada macam-macam. So, itulah dalam unit ni kita akan belajar mengenai sukan. Orang-orang yang apa yang terlibat dalam sukan, athletes, such thing. Okay, benda-benda macam tu. Are you ready to learn? Alright, so for today's lesson, you need to prepare your stationery, your textbook, English Plus 1 CFR Year 5 and your exercise book. Kita dah habis kita dah habis kita punya modul. Okay, jadi kita akan fokus pada latihan dalam textbook. Modul tu tolong siapkan, okay, yang belakang-belakang tu tolong siapkan. Siapa yang selengah sikit siapa yang boleh siapkan semua, yang berjaya untuk siapkan semua latihan dalam modul daripada musa pertama sampai akhir, okay, akan ada hadiah untuk awak bila awak buka sekolah nanti. Okay, alright, so let's back to this. The lesson objective for today, you should be able to fill in the blanks with there was and they are. Okay, ada dua benda yang kita nak tengok hari ini. There was and they are. Sorry, there was and they were. Okay, I'm sorry, there was and they were. Okay, there was and they were ni dua-dua termasuk dalam past tense. Okay, dalam past tense. What is past tense? Ingat tak kita teacher ada terang dulu? Satu timeline, kita duduk tengah-tengah. Kita tu adalah present tense. Sekarang kita panggil present tense. Benda yang dah lepas, kita panggil past tense. Benda yang akan datang, kita panggil future tense. Okay, sekarang kita akan tengok untuk past tense. What is past tense, class? Okay, past tense is the verb tense used for a past activity or a past state of being. Okay, past tense adalah ayat, okay, sentence ataupun satu ayat lah, ayat kata kerja yang kita guna untuk menerangkan benda yang tidak berlaku. Okay, yang telah berlaku, aktiviti yang lepas ataupun keadaan yang lepas. Past ni maksudnya lepas, sudah berlaku. Okay, so past tense also is used, okay, is used to show that you are talking about something that has already happened. Okay, simple past tense, benda past tense ni kita guna untuk bercakap mengenai benda yang telah berlaku. Samalah, okay, benda yang telah berlaku. Ingat, past tense, benda yang telah berlaku. Alright, so ada dua benda yang teacher nak awak tengok, okay. Contohnya past tense ni ayat present tense, benda yang sedang berlaku. There is a party at the house. There is a party at the house. Macam mana kita nak tahu ayat ni ayat yang present, ayat yang sekarang? Okey, tengok yang teacher bulat kat sini, yang teacher merahkan kat sini, is tu menunjukkan present tense. Sekarang macam mana kalau kita nak buat ayat tu jadi past tense? Okey, cara dia kita tukar jadi there was a party at the house. There was a party at the house. Is past tense dia was. Are past tense dia were. Boleh? Bukan where ke apa were. Is past tense was. Are past tense were. Okay? So, ada dua benda saya nak ajar hari ni. Was and were. Ni verb to be Is, are adalah verb to be. Okay, jadi dia punya past tense akan jadi was and were. For example, there was a cat on the sofa. There was a cat on the sofa. Okay, ingat untuk was kita kena guna singular. Okay, untuk satu. Was untuk satu. Awak tengok there was a cat. A cat means satu kucing, seekor kucing. Jadi kita guna was. Bila banyak, there were some cats. on the sofa. There were some cats on the sofa. Cats, kat sini ada S, maksudnya dia plural. More than one, kita guna were. There were some cats on the sofa. Faham? Boleh eh? Alright. Okay, these are the usage. Okay, the usage of was versus were. Macam mana kita nak guna was, macam mana kita nak guna were. Okay. Both was and were are the past tense of the verb to be. Jadi cakap dia, dia adalah past tense kepada is dengan are. However, most of the confusion start with the phrases such as if I was and if I were. Many people use them interchangeably every single day even though it isn't grammatically correct. Okay. Ke I tu seorang betul tak? Kalau dalam I, biasanya kita guna I am. Dalam present tense, I am. Tapi bila masuk past tense, yang mana yang betul Richard? I was ke I were? Okay. Sebenarnya dua-dua betul. Okay, dua-dua betul. Cuma ada cara penggunaannya. Contohnya, okay, untuk I was, awak nak menunjukkan satu keadaan. For example, I hope that I was a good cook when I was younger. Contohnya, saya harap saya seorang yang pandai masak semasa saya muda. Menunjukkan keadaan, saya muda. Sekarang saya dah dewasa kan, bila saya muda. I was. Okay, I was. But if I were, okay, untuk cara nak guna if I were, okay, kita nak menunjukkan benda yang bukan reality. Benda yang kita harapkan. Contohnya, if I were a police, if I were born as a police, if I were born as as an Indian, for example, kan? Sekiranya saya lahir sebagai seorang Indian, contohnya, sekiranya saya adalah seorang polis, if I were, itu kita guna I were. Tengok kan? Untuk was can be used only with the first and third person singular, I, he, she and it. Okay, ingat was ni kan dicakap untuk singular, jadi boleh guna he, she ataupun it. He was talking. She was talking. It was talking. Something like that. Okay, jadi was is used for statement that describe reality. Benda yang sedang berlaku, yang keadaan. Okay, I mean keadaan. Satu state. Okay, untuk were pula, were can be used with the rest of the pronouns you, were, they. Okay, contohnya, you were eating, we were eating, they were eating. Itu semua adalah plural. If you have some subjunctive mood, you need to use were despite the fact that you might be talking about only one person. Sabarlah macam cerita serang tadi, eh? If I were tadi. Okay, so kita tengok untuk gambaran lebih jelas. Okay, macam mana nak guna was dengan were. Tengok eh. Untuk hi, I, he, she, it, was. Okay, kita guna was at the store this morning. Untuk were, kita guna we, you, they. We were, you were, they were. Okay, sebab ramai. We itu kan kami. You, awak. They, mereka. Itu semua ramai. Jadi kita guna were. Okay. Alright. So, now I want you to do some practice. Let's practice. Okay. Cara kita nak guna there was and there were. Okay. Tengok exercise ni. Yang ini kita bincang ramai-ramai. Nanti ada exercise untuk awak. Okay. Untuk number one, there was a tornado yesterday. Tornado tu apa? Apa bunyi puting beliung tu? Ha, yesterday. A tornado. A kat sini menunjukkan satu, singular. Jadi kita guna there was. Number two, many rooms in my house. Oh, tengok many rooms. Ni adalah dia punya apa? Tu kat sini. Many rooms. Bila many rooms, rooms ada S, dia guna many, more than one, plural. Jadi jawapan dia apa? There were. Right? There were. Okay, number three. Dia punya clue adalah four lions. Lebih daripada satu, more than one, right? Four lions in the zoo. Jadi jawapan dia akan jadi apa? There were four lions in the zoo. Right? Okay, number four. Dia punya clue apa? A cat. Okay, a cat. One cat only. Singular. A cat. Jadi dia akan jadi There was a cat in the kitchen. Right? Number five. Okay, agak-agak apa dia punya clue kat sini? Siapa tahu? Alright, clue dia adalah a cake. Okay, a cake. Satu, jadinya there was. Next, number six. 10 eggs. 10 eggs. 10 telur. More than one ke? One only. More than one kan? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. More than one. Jadi, jawapan dia akan jadi there were. There were 10 eggs in the fridge. There were 10 eggs in the fridge. Number 7, dia punya clue adalah books. Books. Okay, bila books ada S tu, dia akan jadi plural. So, the answer will be there were books on the floor. There were books on the floor. Play. Number 8, an old bat in the room. Okay, clue dia adalah an old bat. N kat situ mewakili E lah. Sama sebab O tu A-E-I-O-U kan. Jadi kena guna and. And all that. Singular. So the answer will be there was. Number 9. The clue is a bag. A bag. Satu bag. Jadi dia akan jadi there was. Last one. Many flowers in the park. Many flowers tu adalah clue dia. Dia banyak. Jadi answer will be there were. There were many flowers in the park. Boleh? Jelas eh? Alright. So, now let's look at your homework. English plus 1, CFR year 5, page 65. Teacher nak awak buat exercise dalam buku teks muka surat 65. Sebenarnya semalam, homework semalam teacher dah bagi kan? Muka surat 64. Tapi dah ada yang buat muka surat 65. Teacher suruh buat exercise tu muka surat 64. Tapi ada yang buat. Tak apa. Yang dah buat tu check jawapan awak. Okay, sebab teacher tak ajar lagi awak dah buat. It's okay. Check your answers. And let's look at the clue first. Okay, kita akan tengok. Kita akan bincang cara nak jawab. So, this is the exercise number 2. Complete the text with affirmative and negative forms of there was and they were. Okay, awak kena isi tempat kosong dengan perkataan there was ataupun there were. Okay, untuk yang pertama ni, okay, 2,500 years ago, okay, apa tempat kosong ni? There was ke there were? Dia punya clue adalah a war. A kat sini. Jadi mestilah there was kan? Sebab a, only one. Okay, between Greece and Persia and a lot of battles. A lot kat sini bukan menunjukkan satu eh. A lot tu sini maksudnya banyak. A lot of battles. So, the answer will be apa? There were. Okay. Jadi kat sini, a big battle. A big battle means satu peperangan yang besar. Okay, jadi akan jadi a big. Kat situ jadi there was in a place called Marathon, which Greeks won. This was important news, but, okay, clue dia any internet. Internet tak ada S, jadi jawapan dia there was kan? Bila internet tak ada S, menunjukkan singular, there was. And any telephones, ada S, telefon tu. Jawapan dia akan jadi apa? Ha, fikir sendiri. So, a man called Pheidippides, apa tu nama dia? Pheidippides ran to Athens with news of the battle. He ran about 41 kilometers. Okay. There was ke there were untuk any good roads. Roads ada S, so the answer will be there. Yes, there were. So it was a difficult journey when he arrived in Athens. He died. Okay, ini satu sejarah lah, sejarah mengenai peperangan antara Greece and Persia. Right? isi tempat kosong dengan perkataan there was and there were. Buat dalam buku exercise. Book, salin, exercise number 2. Exercise ni dalam awak punya exercise book. Alright. Okay, so that's all for today class. If you have any problems or any questions, please contact me and I'll try to reply to you as soon as possible. Thank you for attending today's class. I hope you stay healthy. I can't wait to see you. Okay, I can't wait to see you guys soon. Tak lama dah kita nak buka sekolah. Sekali lagi teacher ingatkan, tolong siapkan modul awak sebab awak kena hantar bila awak naik sekolah nanti. On 31 of November, okay, 31st of November, please do your homework in your module, tolong siapkan, dan kerja rumah hari ni pun tolong hantar pada teacher, okay, that's all for today, bye, Assalamualaikum.